Southeast Asia's most aggressive policy tightening coming to an end. The Philippine Central Bank on its Thursday meeting lowered the key borrowing rate by 25 basis points to 6.25%. It's the first rate cut since 2020. It came despite consumer prices in July accelerating to 4.4%. BSP Governor Eli Remolona says that decision came on expectations that inflation would settle within the official target range of 2 to 4%. The central bank now projects annual inflation to fall to 3.3% this year. For 2025, inflation outlook is at 2.9%.
With inflation on a target consistent path, the current macroeconomic outlook supports a calibrated shift to a less restrictive monetary policy stance. Nonetheless, monetary authorities remain mindful of lingering upside risks to prices.
The Philippine peso remains at the 56 to the dollar level. The local currency closed at 56.9 Thursday. It opened at 56.97, its first 56 level in 4 months. The peso had been hovering at the 57 to 58 level in the past months due to the strength of the U.S. dollar. Philippine Finance Secretary Ralph Recto said they expect the peso to hit the 55 to the dollar level by next year. There are no more Philippine offshore gaming operators in Bamban, Tarlac. That assurance given by acting Bamban Mayor Erano Timbang. He says he has always been against POGOs, even as a councilor. He took his oath as acting mayor Wednesday after the ombudsman dismissed Mayor Alice Guo due to her involvement in illegal POGOs in the town. Acting Mayor Timbang says he looks forward to inciting positive change in Bamban in the coming months.
Ang pangunahing layunin po namin ay ang pagpapapaunlad at pagpapabuti po ng kalidad ng buhay sa aming kababayan. Nakatuon po kami sa mga proyektong magdadala ng pagbabago at muli mag-ilom ang bayan po namin ng Bamban. Lalo na po sa mga infrastruktura na magpapadali sa mga pang-araw-araw na buhay ng mga kababayan.
A Philippine lawmaker calls out the police for failing to locate Mayor Alice Guo and Pastor Apollo Kibuloy. Youth Representative Raul Manuel says there is a contrast between how the police arrest big personalities and regular suspects. He also questioned why authorities continue to red tag ordinary citizens while high-profile fugitives walk free. Police Chief Romel Marbil assured the public investigation and surveillance operations are underway to implement the arrest orders against Guo and Kibuloy. A complaint has been filed against former Caloocan Congressman Edgar Arisa before the Commission on Elections. According to the 16-page complaint, Arisa violated Section 261 of the Omnibus Election Code for false and alarming statements concerning the government's preparation for the 2025 midterm elections. The two complainants, who have asked journalists not to divulge their names to the public, filed a complaint through their lawyer, Richard Rosales. The lawyer cited Arisa's comments on Comelec's contract with Miro Systems and the allegations of corruption and bribery against a poll official, among others, as basis of the complaint. In a statement, Arisa said the complaint has no basis and called it pure harassment. Arisa also expressed confidence that he will be vindicated in the end once the Supreme Court issues its ruling on his petition to question the poll body's contract with Miro Systems.
The Philippine Supreme Court seeks comments on the petition challenging the transfer of 20 billion pesos of PhilHealth funds to the National Treasury. Respondents required to submit a comment within 10 days are Senate President Francis Escudero, House Speaker Martin Romualdez, Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin, Finance Secretary Ralph Recto, and PhilHealth President Emmanuel Edesma Jr. Petitioners had challenged the constitutionality of the transfer of excess funds of the state insurer to fund unprogrammed appropriations.